Our next group of ladies changed the course of history and caught the attention of a filmmaker. Wednesdays in Mississippi is a documentary about women who came from other parts of the country to help in voter registration efforts in Jackson during the Civil Rights Movement.
And that's just the beginning of the story this documentary tells. And joining us to talk about the movie are Josie Johnson, Susie Goodwillie Stedman, and Marlene McCurtis. Ladies, welcome to Live at 9 this morning.
Thank you.
It's already being said, this documentary is just so fascinating. And moving, and I guess Marlene, let me start with you. What caught your attention about this story?
Well, I read an article in Crisis Magazine several years ago about these ladies, about Wednesdays in Mississippi, and it really fascinated me. I felt like I was a pretty astute student of civil rights and had never heard this story, and if I was fascinated by it, I felt others really needed to know about it
as well. And what made this one particular story stand out so much?
I think really it was because it was a story about middle-aged women, black, white, Jewish, Christian, coming together across differences and trying to make a difference. And I thought that was a wonderful kind of beacon and a wonderful story to tell.
And Josie, you were in Minnesota at the time, and
exactly.
You had three daughters. You had a family. You
yes.
left them,
yes.
got on a plane on a Tuesday,
right.
did your work on Wednesdays, and then went back to your hometown on Thursdays, but
correct.
You came down to Mississippi.
Yes.
To be a part of all this. Why?
Right.
Why'd you leave your family behind to do this?
Well, I had been a part of a number of civil rights activities throughout my life, and I knew Dorothy Height quite well mm-hmm. through some of our sorority and the National Council of Negro Women, and Dorothy called. And you don't turn down a request from Dorothy Height that
no, you don't,
participate in something as significant as this. As you know, there were a lot of things going on mm-hmm. in 64 and in the South and Mississippi in particular. So the thought of going, and of course had to persuade my husband that it was a worthwhile thing to do, and it was supposed to be a top secret activity, if you'll remember.
Yeah.
We couldn't tell anyone mm-hmm. that we were doing this, only the Attorney General and our family. So it was, I think, a process that we all felt strongly about
yeah.
because it meant something and we were going for that.
And Susie, tell us about that process and your involvement as well.
Well, I went to Africa right out of college and read about the Martin Luther King March on Washington and came back and wanted to be involved in the civil rights movement. I just thought this was a terrible problem and I wanted to be part of the solution. No one would hire me because I was a person of no color. And so a friend of mine introduced me to Dorothy Height, who needed an executive assistant. And Dorothy Height hired me, and I integrated the staff of the National Council of Negro Women.
Wow, wow.
And how long has it been taking you to be able to piece everything together, to get in touch with everyone? Now, right now, you are still in production, is that correct?
We're still in production. We have been at this process for about 5 years. Making the independent documentary is not a simple endeavor.
Yeah. No, not at all.
My partners, we're all working women, so we do this on the side. So it's our passion project, really. So, but it's been a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful adventure and journey meeting these women and learning their stories and being with them.
I also want to ask you, Marlene, what has been the reaction of others, maybe across the state and others you've come in contact with about the documentary itself? I know it's not officially out yet, but what's been the buzz, so to speak?
Well, I think people are fascinated by this story, and I think particularly, you know, when we started this process, Obama hadn't been elected, so we've seen a lot of change in our country, mm-hmm. and I think they really are fascinated by the fact that women have come together across differences, and we're able to have conversations and listen and make change, and particularly today when we look at all the discourse that's going on.
Right.
And the public discourse and how we really are so divided, that this film really and these women are really a shining example of the fact that we can sit and we can listen and we can make change if we engage in conversation.
And it was a dangerous time back in the summer of 1964 and 1965, and you guys put yourselves out there, and you really didn't know what was going to happen to you personally. Was it also because you had daughters, knowing that you wanted them to have the right to vote and not have any issues about voting or having to pay a poll tax or anything? Were you also more inspired because you yourself had daughters?
I had daughters, and yes, I believe all of that. Having grown up in a period when I worked with my father, who was very politically active in Houston, Texas, and we petitioned our community to do away with, abolish the poll tax. So I'd grown up in that environment of working towards something as important as that. So the 64 was, I had been a part of the March on Washington with Dr. King and had been involved in the passage of fair housing in my state and engaged in it. So this appeared to be a wonderful next step.
The last word, Susie, is yours. This is a documentary that we must all see, you think?
I hope so. Absolutely. It's an amazing story. And we were undercover when we did it. And so that it's coming out 50 years later is sort of wonderful.
All right. Has some great information on the screen. There is a special screening, I believe, this evening.
Yes.
At the Brooks at 7 o'clock tonight. And then Wednesdays in Mississippi at the Benjamin Hook Central Library at 3030 Poplar through December 11th.
Choosing to participate, actually.
That's it.
Yes.
Choosing to participate.
Thank you, ladies, so much for sharing this remarkable story with us. We appreciate your time.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.
All right.